gentlemen, what a pleasure to talk to you again, albeit virtually. Wish I was there in Dubai. So first of all, how's the visit been since last night?
We've had a nice day, haven't we?
We've had a wonderful time. Truth is, we've only been here about 12 hours, but so far so good. They've been dramatically and aggressively friendly in all the right ways since we've been here. So we've been having a lovely time.
As a private contractor, you're possessing a unique set of skills.
Jason, when we had the last interview for Wrath of Man, I asked you if there was a sense of familiarity with Guy. So are you guys a little bit like, you know, the odd couple? You know how to work together and how to go around each other?
We do know how to go around each other, but often I end up longer hours in his trailer than out of the trailer. You know, we're always doing something competitive. Who can cook the best steak?
Who can cook the best beef Wellington?
Exactly. I can now.
How'd you?
Yeah, it was one.
Yeah, it was.
What's that?
Power nap.
You said it was clear.
I said the front was clear.
Front, back, right, wrong. Anyway, shall we?
Is this one a little bit different? I felt that the sense of humor of it is different from what you've done before. And how enjoyable is it for you to do this kind of, you know, spy-like comedy?
In reference to Wrath of Man, it was a very internal, solitary kind of story for me to play within. And this one is a much more flamboyant sort of ensemble. There's a lot more colorful sort of language and people, and it's a lot more fun. So I think he, you know, they both have their certain appeal. You know, there can be a bit of a bird's nest at times. These, you know, it's, you know, we have to unravel the dialogue on the day, which makes it quite difficult for us. He's reluctant to give us a script in advance of making these films. That's the one thing you have to get beyond. In other words, you know, it's a tricky sort of route to navigate without having a script, usually, but Guy seems to get his way and we still allow him to do that.
What we got?
Something rather nasty has been stolen. We have to stop that getting onto the open market.
So do you enjoy filming on location, and which one was your preferred location in this one? I think you came to the Middle East, Turkey.
Yeah, well, we fell in love with Turkey, really, didn't we? We were surprised about how much we enjoy Turkey. Fortunately, the studio was very close to the hotel, and we ended up falling in love actually with the culture and the people of Turkey.
Yeah, we couldn't wait to go back. With one of the things I particularly don't like working on stages and you know, being out in the streets and seeing, you know, feeling the atmosphere of people and everything around it is one of the benefits of being in a job that we're in.
Who's the buyer?
Greg Simmons,
the billionaire arms dealer.
Ooh, a lot of very serious faces up here, aren't there?
You can't catch this fish with conventional lures.
I'm sorry?
The lure being?
Danny Francesco.
Let's talk about the characters. First of all, if I was a movie star, I would love to be called Danny Francesco. Who comes up with those names, and how much do you enjoy naming characters?
Yeah, Danny Francesco was, that was a particularly delicious name. But the principle of the film was the ruse de guerre, which was the unconventional rules of war, which it felt like no one had really made a film about, particularly in the spy genre.
The movie star.
Greg Simmons' favorite movie star.
And how do we get him?
Blackmail.
Ruse de guerre. Very good. Carry on.
Jason, what were the spy genres that you watched? I mean, the spy genre in itself is quite diversified. There's the sense of humor ones, like Spy, that you took part a few years ago. What's your favorite subgenre of the genre, and what films did you watch of it?
You know, the typical ones growing up with the Bond sort of movies, the Bourne sort of franchise. That, you know, they're all very kind of seriously embedded in the CIA and the MI5, and, you know, I think to try and throw that on its head and try and do something different without just going along those same lines is quite difficult to do, and trying to inject a bit of this levity into that genre. So I think that's why this one appealed to me, because to do.
Well, we deliberately tried to avoid the CIA. Well, there is no mention of the CIA or the FBI.
Yeah.
We tried to avoid the obvious cliches. When marimba rhythms
start to play. No need to be nervous.
No reason to be nervous. They're all the killers.
You're an actor. Act.
The final question is about brainstorming what movie to do next together in terms of genres. So maybe a cooking film, a musical. What would you say?
Rom-com. Someone mentioned a rom-com.
Exactly. I'd love to see a rom-com directed by Guy with you.
I like the rom-com genre. I also quite like period dramas. So if you fancy doing a period drama, I'm your man.
Powdered wigs and tights. Here we go.
Jason and powdered wig. I'd like to watch that. Gentlemen, thank you very, very much. Wish I was with you, but hopefully see you in person in the near future. Enjoy Dubai.
You weren't seen by anyone? Yes. Or yes, you were seen by someone.
Yes.